This is Numbers chapter 35 and verse 33. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, for blood it defileth the land, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it. Barakatah Yahweh, Barakatah Yahweh Shai, meaning bless you Yahweh, bless you Yahweh Shai, call halal Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Waha Raka Kwadash, meaning all praise to the Most High Yahweh, in the name Yahweh Shai and the Holy Spirit. I want to give double honor to the men who taught me this truth, the apostles and elders of the Great Millstone. Peace and blessings to the hopeful elect that continue in the work of our Lord and our Savior, Yahweh Shai, and all fear, Shalom. Lord willing, this lesson will be edifying. The book of Numbers, chapter 35 and verse 33 again. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, and that ye is concerning the blood shedder. And in this case, the blood shedder is you so-called modern-day white people. All right, you are the number one murderer upon the planet, starting with your forefather Cain in the beginnings, in the garden. It says, for blood it defileth the land. And this land, mainly here in America, which really the whole earth as a whole, all right, but mainly here in America, blood has defiled the land, all right? It says, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein. Now, who blood has been shed therein? The blood of the saints, the blood of the prophets, shed it by you so-called modern-day white people, which are the red Hebrew Edomites, all right? And there is nothing white about you. That's why we call you so-called modern-day white people, because white represents innocence. It represents pure. And there is nothing innocent or nothing pure about you so-called modern-day white people. You are the number one liars, thieves, rapists, homosexuals, all right, and murderers upon the planet. All right, it says, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein. And once again, the saints' blood has been shed mainly here in America, but the earth as a whole, but mainly here in America. All right, and that blood has been shed by you so-called modern-day white people. All right, it says, but by the blood of him that shed of it. All right, so the land, the earth, mainly here in America, shall not be cleansed, all right, but by the blood of him that shed it. So to you so-called modern-day white people, the red Hebrew Edomites, the children of Esau, Esau being the man, Edom being the land, and you so-called modern-day white people are the red Hebrew Edomites, the children of Esau, the children of the wicked, which makes you the wicked that the Bible speaks of. Your blood is the only thing that's going to cleanse the earth, mainly here in America, all right? And we are hasting that day, all right, that your blood cleanse the land, that your blood be shed. Because Galatians 6 and 7 says, a man shall what? Reap what he's sown, all right? And the so-called modern-day white man have sown nothing but rape, robbery, and murder, all right? And that murder leads to bloodshed. And that bloodshed is the blood of the apples of the Most High's eye, all right? The saints, the prophets, all right? The saints representing the children of Israel from the so-called Negroes on down to the so-called Mexicans, Negroes being the children of Judah, the so-called Mexicans being the children of Issachar, all right? And the prophets, those that bring the words, the warnings of the Most High, all right? These Edomites will kill you or hang you right now if they could, all right? Times have slightly changed. When I say slightly, meaning, all right, Esau Edom can't just, you know, jump up on a pickup truck and go run a nigga down, so to speak, but really, they really can, all right? So really, times really ain't changed. That's why I say slightly have changed, you know? But the land cannot be cleansed except for your blood, Esau Edom, all right? You must remember that, all right? You are fugitive on the run, all right? And you are doing your time of judgment, All right, the hammer is about to come down upon you so-called modern-day white people, and you are about to be judged for all the things that you have done. Mainly here in this lesson, we're talking about the bloodshed of the saints. All right, let's read it again, Numbers 35 and 33. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are. And you have polluted the land by shedding the blood of the saints. For blood, it defileth the land. You have defiled the land. All right. When we go to the book of Leviticus, which is the law. All right. Remember, this is the law. Leviticus 17 and round about the 11th verse, it tells us, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. So the life of the flesh is in the blood. So you have shed the lives of the saints, the lives of the prophets, when you shed their blood, man, and defiled the land, defiled the earth, mainly here in America. All right, it says, and I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls, for it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the souls. All right. And that was a law given unto the Israelites, okay, being the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans on down to the so-called Mexicans, all right? The blood was made for us to give an atonement for sins, man, upon the altar. But Esau, Edom, all right, concerning you, you have shed the life, which life is in the blood of the saints and the prophets, man. And you're going to pay for that, man, according to the book of Galatians 6 and 7. You're going to reap what you sown, and you have sown number rape, robbery, and murder. You are full of lies, man. And that murder leads to bloodshed. And that blood is the life, all right, of the saints and the prophets, which are the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, on down to the so-called Mexicans, which are the true Hebrew Israelites, man. You know? So let's jump back to Numbers 35 and 33 again. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, for blood it defileth the land, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein. So there's no way that you can cleanse the blood of the land or the earth, mainly here in America, all right, of the saints and the prophets. The only way that blood is going to be cleansed, how? The scripture says, but by the blood of him that shed it. And that's the blood of you so-called modern-day white people. All right? We don't want any reparations. All right? We want your blood. All right? We want blood. We require blood just like our father required blood. Okay? It's your blood that's going to cleanse this land, man. All right? And the Most High is going to send Yahweh Shai, and Yahweh Shai, through the selective number, all right, men are going to shed your blood, man, to cleanse this earth, man, mainly here in America, man, okay? This is Ezekiel 35 and verse 5, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity and the time that their iniquity had an end. And that's right. Esau, Edom to this day hates you so-called modern-day Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans on down to you so-called Mexicans. All right, this is your captivity, whether you hear or forbear. Perpetual means everlasting or eternal hatred. All right? The scripture says, know thine enemy, man, okay? And your enemy is the so-called modern-day white man, all right? And the so-called modern-day white man, if they could right now, they will shed your blood. They will hang your ass upon a tree right now. They'll put you on a hog, tie you with a rope, and put you on the back of a pickup truck and drag you and stain the streets with your blood from one end of the town to the other end of the town right now, all right? Nothing has changed, man. All right, this shit just been polished up, all right? Esau, Edom, you have a perpetual hatred for us, and we have a perpetual hatred for you, all right? That's why when you read the book of Genesis, when they talk about Jacob and Esau, that's why they struggled in the womb, okay? It was a fight in the womb, all right? Esau want to oppress Jake just like he did in the womb, and Esau has not changed. That's why the scripture says, Ezekiel 35, and 5, because thou has had a perpetual hatred and hath shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity. And the modern day sword is what? The gun. Edomite will shoot your ass down right now. All right? Or shoot you between your eyes right now. All right? If it wasn't so much of a crime. All right? Even though they don't give a fuck about law, they are really above the law. Remember, the earth has been given into the hands of the wicked, which is the so-called modern-day white man, starting with their top-tier elites, which come in the form of the world bankers. But these average Joe Sixpacks, the average hillbillies, these average rednecks, these mountain men, all right, these Yankees, they'll blow your fucking brains out, man, because they have a perpetual hatred for you, all right? Esau Edom doesn't like you Israelites, man. Get that through your head, man, all right? But two-thirds of our people are in love with their enemy, man. That's why you're going to die with your enemy, all right? It says, verse 6, therefore, as I live, saith the Lord, power, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee, sith if thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee, all right? And we always say, the head of my camp, the brother of Rome, me and him always say, that, hey, you got to be running for something to pursue you. And that's why Esau Edom is a vagabond in the earth, man. He's a fugitive. That's why he has taken upon a false identity, claiming that he is the children of Israel, being Jewish, trying to be like the true Jews, man. All right? And that word Jew is short for Judah. So it's impossible for you to be the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. All right, these people are liars. They're rapists. They're homosexuals. All right, they have sex with animals, which is bestiality. All right, they're murderers. All right, so forth and so on. That they are the wicked that the Bible speaks of. Anything up under wickedness, Esau Edom defines it with their actions, man. Every day, all right. It all started back in the garden, in the beginnings, with the first murder. All right, now Genesis chapter 4 and verse 8 says, now this is after our forefather, righteous Abel, and the so-called modern-day white people, all right, forefather, wicked Cain, righteous Abel had made a righteous offering, and the Most High was pleased with our forefather, righteous Abel, offering, and the wicked, which is Cain, the Most High wasn't pleased with his offering because he's the wicked, all right? It's the beginning of his wickedness, okay? And Cain came back in the reincarnation as who? Esau. And our forefather, righteous Abel, came back in the reincarnation as Jacob, which we know later on Jacob's name was changed to Israel, which makes us the true Hebrew Israelites, all right? And you so-called modern-day white people, you are the children or the seed of the wicked bloodline of Esau. Esau being the man, Edom being the land, and you so-called modern-day white people being the red Hebrew Edomites. Now, Genesis 4 and 8 tells us, and Cain talked with Abel, his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and slew him. Yeah, that's that beginnings of that perpetual hatred that we just read in Ezekiel 35, man. Everlasting hatred. And it began right here, okay? It says, verse 9, and the Lord Yahushua said unto Cain, where is Abel thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? See? He was being a smart ass to the Most High, all right? After you just murdered your brother, shedded the life of your brother, which is shedding the blood of your brother upon the land, defiling the land in the beginnings, you sit up here and want to be a smart ass, a wise ass with the Most High. Knowing that the Most High can read your thoughts, he already predestinated for your ass to be the wicked. The scriptures talks about that. Esau Edom being predestinated, as the scriptures said, roughly paraphrasing, doing no good or no evil. All right. When Cain was being conceived, all right, when Abel was being conceived in the beginnings, it was already predestinated who was the chosen seed, who was the chosen bloodline, who was going to be the sons of perdition. Cain being that son of perdition and Abel being that righteous seed. All right, it says verse 9 again, and the Lord Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah said unto Cain, where is Abel thy brother? And he said, I know not, am I my brother's keeper? And verse 10, and he said, what hast thou done? This is the point. The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground. So life was being shedded right then, which is the blood, because we just read Leviticus 17 and 11. Life is in the blood. And you so-called modern-day white people, you love blood. You love shedding blood. You love drinking blood. You love to eat your food filled with blood, eating your fucking food medium rare. See? You're just a bloodthirsty vampire. You are the modern-day bloodthirsty vampire, man, which makes you a wicked man, all right? And your blood is going to cleanse this land, all right? These are the words of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah, and we are delivering these words, all right? We are just the messengers, okay, to deliver the words, the saints, all right? The Most High have revealed his secrets unto us, all right? And we are delivering these words to you so-called modern-day white people. You're going to pay for all the things that you have done, starting with your forefather Cain in the garden, all the way down into the last Jake that has been murdered by a so-called modern-day white man. All right? Verse 11, and now art thou cursed from the earth, which have opened her mouth to receive thy brother's blood from thy hand. You was a blood shedder from the beginning. You love to shed blood, man. That's the trait of the so-called modern-day white man. It is evident. It has been made clear. It has been manifest, all right, that you are your forefather, all right, because you have the same deeds. You came back in the same lot, and you are doing the same thing that your forefather Cain did, shedding blood, man, defiling the land, man, all right, and the Most High is going to give you blood to drink, all right, because you have not hated blood, all right. This is Revelation chapter 16 and verse 6. And it reads, for they have shed the blood of saints and prophets. And who is the they? Starting with Cain, the wicked, all the way down to Esau, and Esau all the way down to his wicked seed line, which are the so-called modern-day white people, which are the red Hebrew Edomites. For they, that's the they, have shed the blood of the saints and the prophets. Who are the saints and the prophets? Starting with our forefather, righteous Abel, on down to Jacob, which later on his name was changed to Israel, and we being the Hebrew Israelites, which are the children of the righteous seed, all right? Our blood has been shed for thousands and thousands from the beginning, all right? Upon the land, upon the earth, and mainly here in America in this modern 2019, the year of Karagma, the year of the microchip. All right, the scripture says, Revelation 16 and 6, for they have shed the blood of saints and prophets, and thou hast given them blood to drink, for they are worthy. And there is no race of people upon the planet that is worthy for their blood to be shed than the so-called modern-day white man. All right, every race of people, even other Edomites, can attest to a white man being the wicked, the white man being more wicked than any other nation upon the planet. And they are bloodthirsty monsters, all right? And they're going to get dealt with according to the King James Version, according to the words of Yahweh Shah, all right? Or should I say the words of the Most High, which is Yahweh Shah. I got to get it, Galatians chapter 6 and verse 7. And it says, be not deceived, all right? The Most High is not mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. All right? And Esau Edom has reaped nothing but corruption. Verse 8, for he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. And Esau is a fleshly man. He is a carnal man. He is a terrestrial man. All right? And he's going to receive corruption because that's what they have reaped, man. It says, but he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. And that's the righteous seed of our forefather, righteous Abel. All right, we're going to reap life everlasting. Even the two-thirds. Once again, like I said in the last lesson, even the two-thirds are going to come back through the loins of the elect and the kingdom in righteousness. All right, therefore all of Israel shall be saved. All right, but Esau, Edom, you being the wicked, you being the blood shedder, those that love blood, that's what you're going to reap. Your blood cleansing the land, and that's the day that we're hastening. Lord willing, I pray that this may edify. Shalom and death to America.